everybody, what is up? My name is Astercat, and welcome back to Night in the Woods. Last episode, some things went down. We had a conversation with Angus and Gregg about how we needed to let Gregg change, and it was really good, a conversation that needed to happen. I feel like some people didn't handle things in necessarily the best way, but then they talked about it, they talked about how they handled it, they talked about, you know, Angus apologized for not treating them very well. May having the idea to bring their child out into the woods. That sounds really wrong out of context, but you know, their robotic child that was causing a lot of tension between Angus and Gregg. I noticed that actually. That's one of the things that I noticed when we first brought the robot home, was that Angus never said anything about liking it or being okay with it being in their house. And so like, I was kind of tense about that, and so to have it clearly end up like him just being like, it smells, like going back to that, clearly it's something that's been on his mind a lot, but he didn't want to be rude, and I think him holding that in caused him to react the way he did, to where when he finally reached his limit, he just kind of snapped. And then Gregg was like, what the frick is wrong with you? And anyways, I'm glad they were able to talk it out. I hope that we're able to move forward with this in a healthy way. I'm really excited and nervous. Music fills empty spaces. Deep hollow hollowers. Or hollers? Why did I get that achievement? Oh, well, I have no idea what that achievement is for. But yeah. Good morning, Meg. Let's check. Checky, checky, checky. Ooh, messages from everybody. Okay. Science beat. New research indicates that things don't necessarily have to be as bad as they are. Hello, May. Pickaxe. At it, me. You know the drill. Yep. Hey, kid. Snack falconing. Work, work, work. Till I die, die, die. My message. Come pick your fight. Give arrows flight. You mess with me, you mess with all of us. Going to the blank tones next week. Cool. I don't know what that means. I guess we will head on out then. Oh, we can look at the picture today. Jeez, feels like it's been years since I got back and saw this again. It has been a while. I don't know, I feel like it's simultaneously been a really long time and not a lot at all. This game's atmosphere and its storytelling is so unique and so incredible. Like, I don't know, I've mentioned it before, but the way that last episode went with that whole conversation, they're able to put you into May's shoes really well. Hey bird, things are like really intense right now. Pray to your bird gods for my soul, bird. Yeah. I'm definitely a little nervous about today. Let's see if mom has anything to say. Good morning. There's my little sunshine daisy. Are you feeling better from the other day?
Sleeping a lot, but feeling worse.
Okay, well, I'm going to make an appointment with Dr. Hank.
Oh, geez, mom, it's fine.
It's very much not fine, hun.
I'm an adult, I can make that decision.
When you're here, you're still my baby. I'm making you an appointment. May, hon, I'm worried about you.
I'm okay, mom. Listen, I keep thinking about the money problems and the house. I'm just so sorry we wouldn't be in this situation if I wasn't such a massive screw-up. I just want to fall into a pit and die right now.
May, it's okay, really. We'll figure something out. This isn't on you to fix. I'm sorry if I made it seem that way.
What's...
Done is done, and we're a family together regardless. Please stop worrying about it.
Whatever happens, I love you. I need you to know that.
You too.
Oh, I don't like those words. Okay, I'm gonna go.
You sure you don't want to stay home and rest?
Nah, got stuff to do.
What is it you have to do?
I don't even know, honestly.
Oh, hun. Please take it easy.
I will.
Love you.
Love you too. I'm really worried about you.
I keep the really good prescription headache meds on my nightstand. I'll, like, give you half of one.
Only half?
Honey, you're, you know...
short.
Half would be fine.
It's fine, Mom.
Okay, let me know if I can be any help.
Thanks, Mom.
Okay. Guess we're heading out.
Tension is building and I don't like it.
Hi, Rabies!
Hey, Rabies. How's life? That's good to hear. Back in school, we had to write this thing. Like, if you could be anywhere in 15 years, where would you be? It was an easy assignment, because I drew it when I was 15. It hasn't changed, except it was 20 years then. I want a farm or something like that. Not with like animals or crops or something. Maybe corn? I like cornfields. Maybe here, maybe in like Idaho or something. And we're there, she's there. In the drawing, she. And we're married. Or no, like whatever they do in Idaho. My teacher wrote, I think that they just get married. But no, I mean like out in the frontier. You stay with someone long enough that it's just a thing. Whatever, I can call it what I want. That's really sweet, oh my god! Anyway, we go out and wander around and do work together. We come home and we're all gross and your face feels like it does when it's been windy all day. It's cold out. We order pizza. My teacher was like, on a farm? In Idaho? Yeah, there's a town nearby in this drawing. It was a big drawing. And we eat pizza and I'm playing a video game and she's making something. Like she does woodworking or she's a blacksmith or something. So she has really rough hands. Teacher was like, she's doing woodworking and or blacksmithing in the living room. And she has boots, but like, mine are muddy. But hers are all scuffed up from work, from the wood or the fire or something. We have two big burly cats from a barn and a dog. And we all howl at the moon together. Parts of it I've wanted since I was a kid. The cats and the dog at least. No children. No children. No children. How about you, Rabies? Does Rabies want babies? Do you have big plans? Too true, Rabies. Too true. Alright, I'm off. Thanks for saying hello. See you around. Be safe and eat trash. And common pests. That was really good. Oh my god. That's a future that, like... I don't know. I feel that way sometimes about the future, too. Of just... I just want to be able to live a life that I don't hate. And not saying, like, that automatically means that I hate life, like, now or anything. But, like, you're constantly worrying about what you're going to do in the future when all I really want to do in the future is to be able to keep doing the things that I love doing. Also, I noticed when I was... So, we got a little, like, notification that our journal was high. Updated. I'm going to talk about this first. Oh, God. What do you want? Hello to you too, May. Well, I wanted to let you know. We ran a test on that arm you guys found a few days back. Has it really only been a few days? Oh, really? Yeah, I thought you'd be interested as all. Definitely. Arm belonged to a middle-aged man and a medium build. He was dead when it was removed. Whoa. That means... It doesn't mean anything yet. I just thought you'd like to know. You always liked detective stories when you were a kid. Okay, yeah, thanks. This ghost is seriously messed up. Ghost? Wasn't no ghost involved in this, whatever it was. Yeah, nobody believes me, I get it. Be careful, May. Strange stuff going on. Yeah, you're telling me. Have a nice evening, May. Okay. Well, sorry! As I was saying, I noticed... I was like, I got a notification that the journal was updated, and I could not figure out what it was, and I realized we found another pentagram, apparently. That's very strange, though. Hey, Selmers! Hey, Selmers. Cheese, May, are you sick? Nah. Just tired. Got a headache. Why are you out running around? I'll get over it. Yeesh. Take it easy, neighbor. Can do. Wanna hear a new poem? Mm-hmm. Sure. Stars, the stars, like lights on cars. Drive across the dark and never park. It's true, they are like that. I got one ready for longest night. Oh? Longest night. Longest night. Night so dark, but stars so bright. Nice. Thanks, I'm feeling festive. Cool. You noticed anything, like, weird around here lately? Weird as in... Missing kids? I don't think so. Not recently, at least. That Casey kid last spring. But you weren't a kid no more. Maybe someone else, but from another town? Sure, I'll remember. You know, I asked that, but didn't expect you to know. I read the paper. Forecast is thinking snow soon. When? Soon. Gonna get cold soon. Ugh. Gross. Hate the cold. Hello! Getting colder this year. Don't bode well. Okay, well, I hate the cold, so, yeah. I don't like the idea of it getting cold early. Oh! What? Sorry! Can see Penderson's house from here. What a ghoul that guy is. He has hated me forever. just because I put an M80 in his roof, down his roof gutter. A what? Okay, it's an explosive. I didn't know what that was. I mean, it's just petty, this grudge. That was like forever ago. No, May, that's a kind of a valid thing to be upset about. I have such a pattern for how I take each of the sections. That way I don't forget anything. Can we visit? Oh wait, I don't think, speaking of not forgetting anything, I don't think we visited where our rats were in forever. We should do that. I can't believe I forgot. Oh, hi, you're here. The tunnel fish will always be there. Will tunnel drain and I'll be bare. I would miss the tunnel fish. To have them back would be my wish. Are they gonna drain the tunnel or something? No, it's poetry, okay? I'm just making stuff up. Please don't listen. I'm sorry, you're talking out loud. We haven't seen Miss Rosa in forever. Teenagers, are you down here? No? Okay, no teenagers today. Up to the church we go. So somebody was talking, they were talking about Bruce, and Bruce's whole thing did seem very sad. Somebody said that his daughter was dead, but I don't remember him ever actually confirming that. All that happened was that we said something about his daughter, and that he was like, that we were like, oh, you have a daughter, or you have a kid, and he didn't seem to want to talk about it, and that was it. So I don't know what's up with that. I'm hoping Bruce is okay. Okay, yeah, did that when my daughter was born. You have a daughter. Yep. Where is she? Dot dot dot. Sorry. It's fine. So like, he never actually said that she was dead, so I kind of was hoping that she wasn't. I don't know. I didn't want to assume the worst, I guess. We'll just have to see. I don't know who to go to first. See, you can't resist coming here. That's God calling you. Oh geez, I'm betting not. God's patient, hun, like nature. That is such a creepy statement. I find it comforting. I got this creeping dread thing going on, so just ignore me. Okay, hun, can I do anything? Not really. Love you. What is it? I don't know. Purposely committing this scene to memory. Taking a brain photo. I don't like this, May. Yeah, like when I was a kid. Your dad was great with the games to keep you quiet in the car. He sure was. I still do it now. Got your picture. Snap, snap. Got yours too. Love you, sweetie. You too, Mom. I'm so worn out. Why don't you go take a nap back in the library room? Oh, wow. Haven't been in the library room in years. It doesn't get a lot of use these days, but it's nice and quiet and peaceful. Okay, I might do that. Door back there's unlocked now, so have at it. I'll be out here. Thanks, Mom. No problem, sweetie. Oh, I was wondering if we were... I kept checking back there to see if anything was going on, but... Let's see, is Pastor K here? No. Yeah, I bet she's probably out where Bruce is. The room that was in the rats! Or... I don't know what I just said. The room that was in the room with the rats. Oh, wow. It actually does look really nice here. Oh. May. Hi. That's really sweet. This is such a sweet moment. I don't want it to end, but I've been sitting here for a while, and so I'm like, I'm assuming... Oh, May. Because I'm assuming that's her granddad. I'm lucky enough to still have 3 out of 4 of my grandparents, and the only one who's passed, I only met him like 3 times. To God, I can only imagine, but this is so... so sweet. Oh. Oh, that was awesome. Pastor K, are you here? We got statues of stern dudes for miles here in Possum Springs. Yeah. Yeah. Wonder where Bruce has got to. Actually, I know.
Really?
Yeah, he told me not to tell you yesterday.
Tell me what, May?
Bruce is going home.
He... what?
Yeah, he's going home to his kids. I guess they're all waiting for him.
Oh.
He seemed pretty happy about it.
Okay. Thanks, May.
Are you not happy about this?
Thanks for letting me know.
See, because I had feared that things were bad. I don't know. I didn't want to assume. I hope it's not. I hope he's okay. Hello? Okay, nothing new here. What about this room over here? Yes, there are definitely things to look at. Seriously, there's no bathroom in here, and none outside this room. They poop in this dresser? Oh god. They poop in a bucket? Oh geez, what if I stumble across the poop bucket? There are unanswered questions here. Wonder if it's a guy or gal. They're probably pretty old. No one young cares about the saints or church. Gonna be weird in like 30 years. Not all the churches are empty. I'll open a pizza place. Sit in the pews and eat pizza. Gotta come up with a pun. Combining pizza and church. Holy pepperoni. I could sleep in this bed, and whoever lives here would never know. They'd go to sleep. Tonight. Unaware someone else was just there, under their sheets, on their pillow. Mwahaha. Could also, like, be helpful. Could make their bed when they don't. This doesn't have to be creepy. I think that would still be creepy, May. Wonder if whoever lives here knows I've been here. I feel like we have some relationship. Like I'm a ghost, and I'm haunting them. I should, like, move something. Just let them know someone cares enough to visit them. Okay, I'm not gonna do that. That would be the creepiest thing ever. I think so. Alright, well, glad we did that. I'll have to remember to check that room more frequently. It's so lovely to see my rats out and about through the town. Alright, nobody playing violin. I guess we'll have to go check on, see if they're there today. Hi, Lori.
You okay?
Yeah. I'm, like, only half here right now. I'm just tired.
Are you sick or something?
I don't even know anymore.
You should get some cold medicine and some crackers and ginger ale and lay in bed and watch bad movies.
Thanks for the advice, Doc.
Don't mention it. May? You okay? May!
Sorry, spaced out there for a sec.
You should, like, see a doctor.
I'll get around to it. Thanks.
No problem.
Alright, well, I'll probably see you later.
Probably?
Nothing certain, I guess.
Okay.
See ya. May, no. Okay, I guess we'll keep going.
Maybe.
Whoa.
Dude, are you okay?
Yeah, I guess, sure. Tired, had a headache for days.
You should, like, go home and rest. I feel like you'd be able to veg out pretty well.
No, I'm fine. Doing stuff helps.
How are you feeling about the whole ghost thing?
Bad. I mean, since it happened, I don't feel rested in the morning. And I feel like someone else is in my head. My skull is going to explode.
So yeah, not good then.
Nope.
You still want to check out the graveyard?
No, not today.
Okay, well, let me know.
Yeah, she's definitely worried. That was a very friendly interaction. Not that it's usually not friendly, but, like, that was more friendly than normal. You're worrying people, May. Not that that's necessarily your fault, but I'm worried, your friends are worried, your mom is worried. Angus? So, I said I could, like, take you up to the park. You did indeed. I'm so tired. You gonna be okay?
Yeah, I'll be fine.
You up for the park trip?
Nah, not yet. I want to talk to Gregg first.
And then probably, because I'm assuming based on that, we won't be able to hang out with Gregg today. I guess we're checking on our music people early today. How are you guys? Ooh, birds! Whee! All right, hello. Hey. Hey. Hello. You guys gonna play together?
Yeah.
Thanks for making this happen, kid.
Oh, wow.
Huh.
What?
I just realized that, like, I did something helpful. Like, I came up with a plan and did something good.
Is that strange?
I feel like I just stumble into things all the time. Introducing you two is like, I meant it to help two strangers, and I did. And now you're gonna play together.
Fall in love?
What? No.
I don't know how to pronounce that word, actually.
Monogamous, I think?
I am not in the market. My son takes up most of my attention.
Oh. Did I make it weird?
You made it weird.
Very weird.
Damn it.
Cool. Well, I like your playing. That's awesome. Have fun, you two.
Hello.
What's in the news?
Birds flying south early this year.
What does that mean?
They know something we don't.
Sure! And other usual things to say in a conversation. Smelters, people!
Well, that's it. Shipping out tomorrow.
Can't believe I actually landed the new job.
Yep, moving on to better things.
Kids excited?
Oh yeah, they'll love it. Might take a while. Well,
yep.
Yep. Maybe just one more, huh?
Yeah, one more.
Go Smelters!
Yep.
Aww. Well, that makes me so sad.
I didn't mean to talk to Gregg, actually. Hang on. Sorry, Gregg. I'll be back. I'm doing this out of order. I just talked about having an order, and I'm messing up the order by going to talk to you. I didn't mean to do that.
Hi!
Hey, Jerm.
Hey, May. Totally, what's up? Other than the obvious. You seem something, too.
Do I look any different?
To me, you do.
Thanks for your attention.
Do you want to come? Got a trampoline?
Sure.
Alright, let's go.
This could end terribly. This is really weird.
Why?
I, like, never pictured you coming from somewhere. Thought you just, like, appeared one day in a parking lot.
Oh.
Sorry, that was weird.
It's cool. A lot of folks from town never come back up here.
Got a lot of cars.
My uncles are here a lot. They fix cars with my dad.
Do you drive?
I bike. Better for the environment.
I just keep finding things out about you.
What? We're all gonna die from temperatures and water.
Is this your tire?
Nah, it's for my sisters and my cousins.
You have sisters?
Yeah, they're out at church stuff right now. That's why I invited you over. It's like adults night here.
Adults night?
One night a week, no kids.
Cool.
Okay, you should meet my mom.
Should I?
It's polite since you're eating dinner here.
I was kidding.
I couldn't tell.
You okay?
I'm nervous.
Why?
Come on.
Hi.
Hey, Mom. This is May. She's eating dinner with us.
Hi. Hello, May.
Hope you like
Sloppy Joe's. Who doesn't? Nobody in this house.
I thought you two should meet before dinner.
That's very thoughtful, Jeremy.
I'm gonna introduce May to Gamma. Grandma.
Oh, is that what this is about? What?
Can I?
You don't need my permission. Whatever happens is on you.
What? Come on.
Nice meeting you.
You too, May.
This is uncomfy. I am uncomfy.
Oh, here she is.
Sturdy girl. My granddad said that. Did you?
This is Grandma.
Hello.
Mm-hmm. Okay, well, see ya.
Wait, what? You're looking at me.
Sturdy's a good word for you. Big bones, stout.
Yep. So, is that it?
Oh, I'm sorry. Did I upset you?
No.
Too bad. You need to be upset. What's coming to you, little girl? Three times the trouble you deserve. You're going to go down hard, not far from here. You will go down in these woods.
Are you, like, telling my fortune?
Little girl, I don't know what you did.
You got a dark spot in you that one day is going to take a life. Might be someone else's or it might be yours.
Okay.
Mark my words. You're doomed.
Okay, I'll try to remember that. Or actually, no, this is stupid. You don't know me. Whatever it is that's wrong with me, yeah, I'm not just an effing shell for my problems to walk around in. You got a dark spot on you? What the actual hell do you know about me anyway?
Can't stop what's coming. But ask you a question you can't answer. Can you unhaunt a haunted house?
What?
Eh. Had you go in there for a second.
What?
I'm just joshing you. I have my fun.
What is wrong with you? That was seriously messed up.
You're a good sport. You go outside now, dear. Let Grandma watch Judge Janice.
Yes, you're around.
Not likely. Little girl.
Mm-hmm. That was rude.
Don't tell me what Grandma said.
Why?
When Grandma tells you something for you, it's yours. And if you give it away, it's gone.
What does that mean?
Watch this.
Cool! Holy crap!
Come on!
Okay! Bet! Oh, this is fantastic! Hello! Hey, there's a familiar face. What? I've seen you a whole bunch.
I'm invisible! Don't let him spook you. He's been working on your street. Department of Transportation. You don't see us, but we see you.
Oh, yeah. Hi. Thanks for fixing our street.
Yep, yep. We're nothing.
He's been doing the easy work. My crew's been out climbing all over the bridges in Saltstown. Oh, they open yet?
Hell no. That'll be the day.
Just to re-barity.
What?
Nothing. You're Stan Borski's kid, right?
Yeah.
We see him down at Miller's a bunch. Probably good to see him less now.
Yeah. He mean nothing by it.
It's cool. Back when your dad was something else. He's up at Ham Panther now, right?
Yeah.
They're pretty anti-union, huh?
Yeah, he's mentioned that.
Hmm. Yep, yep. Your dad's alright, kid.
Okay. Yeah, he's good.
How do you know my dad?
I don't. I just felt left out of the conversation.
You're so real for that, Jim.
You tell him Hand Panther Management could go straight to hell.
Okay, that's, weird.
Ain't nothing weird about it. Jeremy, we gotta go to...
Are we going out to Hunwick this weekend?
Yeah.
What's in Hunwick?
Old computer shell!
I'm gonna look for an old Compudon 80.
Play some Wanderers of Lorgan.
Bunch of dweebs over here.
Yep, yep.
Okay, well, if I bounce anymore, I'm gonna puke.
No need to keep bouncing. I'm not gonna be lonely.
Alright. So, why?
Dinner! Hold that thought.
That was really good.
Glad you like Sloppy Joe's.
Who doesn't?
What were you going to say before dinner?
Oh, yeah. Weird to ask, but why did you invite me up here? I don't think even Gregg's been up here.
Nah. Gregg's cool, but, like, Gregg's got things pretty much figured out.
Yeah, Gregg's the best.
Like, it seems like you've been having a hard time lately, and I thought you'd just like to, like, chill out for a bit. Everybody else is, like, going somewhere, or wishes they were. You're just, like, not. I don't know.
Yeah. Thanks for dinner.
Thank my mom.
No, just thanks. I've had a really long fall.
I know. Glad you like Sloppy Joe's.
Who doesn't?
Say no to that? That was so good! Oh my god!
Gotta go now.
Bye. And it's here, and there's a trampoline. He's from somewhere. Wow. Grandma, Germ's got a whole family. Delicious Germ, a good guy. Wow, that was awesome. Thank you, Germ. I feel like May really needed that today.
All right, now it's Gregg time.
Hi, Gregg.
Hey, man.
Hey.
How you holding up?
Got a splitting headache. Feel like I've barely slept, even though I slept a lot.
Geez, you okay?
I don't know.
Can I do anything?
Kill me?
Bang. I shot you.
Thanks.
So what are you up to today?
Just saying hey.
Hey!
All right, Angus it is then. And then we'll do B when we go through the whole thing with B.
Yeah. Wow, B let you have the car 2 nights in a row?
Yeah.
Even after the flat tire?
Well, I mean, you can't really do anything about that. I replaced the tire.
Oh, yeah. We could borrow our car, though. I had to ride on Gregg's bike. We saw that ghost.
Yeah, Gregg needs to get his license.
I fell off his bike.
Which I also did a few days before that.
So you think you got the guy you saw was a ghost? Not a guy, a ghost.
Right.
How does no one believe that it was a ghost?
Well, I mean, ghosts don't actually exist.
I'm pretty sure they do.
Well, I'd need evidence.
What counts?
A ghost walking up and saying hello? Me saying, hey, I verified you are a dead person.
Could be a zombie or Frankenstein.
Okay, maybe if they're made of ghosty stuff.
Ghosty Stuff can be our podcast about ghosts.
This episode of Ghosty Stuff brought to you by Donut Wolf.
No, I'm gonna be sick.
Sorry.
Welcome to Ghosty Stuff. I'm May and I saw ghosts and this is Angus who doesn't believe me.
I'm Angus and this is May. She's a crazy person.
Cute, the park. Oh boy.
Let's hope this is a little less stressful than Gregg's.
I feel like I could use that. Nice evening.
Yeah, it's alright.
My mom used to take us up here to play frisbee.
I got hit in the teeth with the frisbee once full speed.
Jeez.
Casey and me were throwing things at each other's heads.
Oh.
We stopped after the frisbee.
Yeah. Understandably so.
Okay, can't go that way.
We are trapped within the confines of the screen.
It is very nice out.
Posted. Do not feed or touch the wildlife. Well, clearly. There's some folks living in cabins up here. You can, feed and touch them if you want.
It's a weird old place up here. There's all kinds of weird stuff back up in the park. Old stuff just hanging out in the woods.
But my old scout camp on the way up, I think.
Busy woods.
Okay, better get going before it gets dark.
Mm-hmm. Wow, it's really pretty out. I need to go outside more. Can we go up? Wait, can we go up? Okay, now. Wasn't sure. Hi, Angus. I'm gonna run past ya. Oh, I can go up. Wait, should I go up? Where are you going?
You alright?
Yeah, I got asthma as well. Sorry you got away from me.
Do you have an inhaler?
Yeah, but I saved that for emergencies. Being slow isn't an emergency.
What is this thing?
This is like a lime kiln, I think. Limes? Limestone.
Oh!
You do something with it in there and it becomes this other thing.
Oh.
Limestone's weird because it's mostly made of skeletons and sea creatures from millions of years ago. So like, this was all underwater or something at one point.
Whoa.
I know, right? Like right where we're standing. They're like ancient horrible sea monsters.
Creepy and awesome.
That's history. Okay, I'm ready to go.
Cool! Up, 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 we go! Another one.
Need to take a break?
I'm okay. I'm okay. No problem.
So if this place was underwater,
why aren't there like ancient shark bones up here?
I don't know. It might be, I guess. Not everything becomes a fossil.
Why?
I don't know. I'm not an expert on any of this. But there were definitely ancient sharks around here.
Weird because things are so boring nowadays. I think all that crazy stuff was going on here.
There's always more weird stuff that happened. Find out about later. Okay, I'm ready to go.
Oh, cool.
Interesting. We got ahead of me.
Are you sure you're okay?
Yeah.
Sorry.
Seriously, it's fine. Hang on. Hang for a minute.
Okay.
I should know all this stuff about, like, ancient sea creature rock or whatever.
Lime. Stone.
I was gonna take a class on dinosaurs back at school.
What happened?
It's all full up. Class fills up fast.
I bet.
I love dinosaurs.
Who doesn't?
Things were so scary and cool back then. We'd die in like 5 minutes.
Oh yeah, ancient creatures would eat us, no problem. Be glad for the millions of years between us.
Weird.
Time, dude.
Time makes most dangerous things less dangerous. Most things, at least.
Okay, you ready to roll?
Yeah, we're almost to the top.
Almost there!
Wow.
Well, my old scout camp used to come up here with my troop. Like a decade ago. You're the ancient sea monster now. Looks like it. Oh. Wow! Whoa, I fell! Wow, looks like some of the whirly note things came back. The what? We made these little windmill things. Oh! And each put an anonymous note in them, attached to this little spring-controlled helicopter. And the idea is when the wind would pick up, the windmill would wind up the helicopter and the note would fly away. Looks like some of them blew back. That's an amazing coincidence. Oh no, that was the idea. Each year we'd read notes left from the year before. I'm gonna see if I can find any more. I'm gonna hike up here. Been a while. Oh cool, they really are there. Got one. Two. Got one. Three. Got one. Last one. Got one. Awesome. Let's go take him to Angus. I'm glad we did that. So that's why we did the windmill thing. Windmill things. Think you got them all? From what I can spot, at least. And I got the high vantage point. Let's read them. Let's read them. Wait, should we though? We gotta leave them for the scouts. Oh, it's fine. Anyone's up here wouldn't last the winter anyway. Okay, let's read one. Okay, here's one. Hi. Not supposed to write my name, and that's fine, because I am a scout. And that is the only name I need. Wow, that's intense. It goes on. The scouts gave me more than a name. They gave me badges to show my worth. Jeez. I would kill for the scouts. That's it. Were you all like this? Kinda, sometimes. No, maybe. Okay, let's read this here. Read it! Oh dear. What? I am super, super gay. Nice. Angus, did you write this one? Jeez, I could have. I think my note was about being being strong and good. And gay as hell, apparently. I think my total gayness came through the discerning reader. Alright, let's read this note. Okay, so very random cut. I just accidentally hit the power switch with my foot and shut my computer off. This is the first time this has happened. I checked. The recording I had done did save, so I think we should be good there. I don't know where the game's gonna put us if I press continue. Okay, not too far back. Cool. Anyways, I'm gonna catch back up and I will see you guys in a second. We're about back, and I have to say, I think that was super homophobic of my computer. All right, let's read this note. Okay, yeah. Oh, I think this part cut out, actually. In fact, I think we should shoot arrows instead of guns when we're in the army. It has a tactical advantage in that it is silent and also elegant. Huh. Yeah, I got nothing. All right, this one got kind of torn up. Okay, I've not seen this. Maybe a bird got it. Read the bird note. I am extremely unhappy and you're the only person who knows. Oh, okay. What? Not much changes. Could have just as easily been our notes from 10 years ago. Yeah. There's like timelessness about people. Some things just don't stop being what we are. Oh, it's dark. Well, that was a hike. That was a lot easier than when I was 11. We passed, what, 3 gates on the way up here? I lost count. Weird, used to be open back then. Ready to go? Not far now, just up ahead. I don't like it, it's dark. Graves, huh? Yeah, these were, I forget. They were involved in the Possum Massacre. That like labor strike thing, where it was like the miners versus the National Guard. Happened back in town like 100 years or so ago. Why are they up here? I think these were some of the bad guys and some of the miners. Didn't want them buried in town. Oh, huh. A few old graveyards up here from like Colonia. Is that one of the words that... Anyways, I guess there's one up here somewhere too. Well, that's spooky. Just bones. Ancient shark bones. Yeah, see? Nothing left to be scary. I'm spooked. I don't like being places at night. I'm more so afraid of getting in trouble than anything, though. Wow, we're up really high. And really far out. I can't see town from here. It's south of us, way behind whatever that ridge is. So what, are we just supposed to wait here and see if anything happens?
You tell me, you're the expert.
So just wait here and see if anything happens.
Nice night.
Yeah. Back at school, I couldn't see as many stars. It always made me sad. Oh yeah, they're really nice up here. I wish I knew the constellations like you did.
What?
You know all the names and the stories and stuff.
I wish. I can never remember them other than that one up there is like a bell or something.
Oh, no, no, no. Remember the time we were on the longest night bonfire? We spotted the constellations together and you told us all about them?
That's not a thing that happened.
Well, maybe it was like a dream or something. God, I barely remember now. I wonder what fake constellations and stories you dreamed up.
Okay, humor me.
I'll find the constellations, you tell me about them.
Okay, then.
Okay.
Alright, find me some constellations. Wait, are these gonna be real ones or fake ones?
Just ones I remember, or dreamed that one time.
Ugh. Whichever.
Remember Mr. Chazkov?
Yeah, science teacher.
He was in Underhill and has a telescope on his roof, and I totally saw some stars through it.
That's cool. Telescopes are cool. Wish I had a telescope.
Okay, let's see. This one. Oh! Am I just not getting it accurately, or is it telling me that I can't? This is so cool. There we go. Oh!
Okay. That's a bell, and the middle is his eye, looking at you. Okay, that's I know this one a little from, like, prog rock album covers.
I think you die when it rings and it's looking at you.
Oh crap. It's high up enough, it's kinda always looking at all of us, right?
God damn. Yeah. It's a cat. He's got arrows sticking out of him. And he's chasing a diamond.
Oh, I know this one. Don't remember his name. He lived, you remember the stories about the forest god?
No.
It's a whole bunch of stories. There's this person, Adina, and-
Oh yeah, Adina and the Frozen Lake.
Yeah, that's one of them. Anyway, this cat was in there. Like shiny things, good at getting through the forest. He was really good at stealing.
Oh, well, yeah, I used to call him Ass Cat when I was little.
Well, then he stole a diamond from King, got arrowed to death. But he was slick enough that he jumped out of his body. Became immortal or something.
Huh, decent.
Extremely decent.
Cool! What about this one?
It's a pope. He breathes fire. Oh, this one is real. Or at least the dude is.
Bellio. There's a statue of him outside church.
Oh, we never went there. Did your family go to church? Weddings and funerals and longest night, basically.
I don't think those first two count.
Those are like events.
My mom works up at the church now. I haven't gone really since I was 14 or 15.
Does she mind?
She pretends not to.
Yeah. It's a whale.
And it's got like the world on its back.
Oh wow, that's sad.
Yeah. Kind of a lot of responsibility.
Did the whale consent to this?
I think it just always was that way.
Oof. You gotta wonder why people made these up. I mean, like, these specifically. Who saw a whale and was like, it needs to be carrying something.
I mean, whales are pretty big.
What's the whale swimming in?
Space.
I guess it's dumb to get mad at ancient people.
They're like way out here, huh?
In the bark? Yeah, I guess. Spooky.
I don't know, it's pretty safe.
And the stars are pretty.
So you don't believe in ghosts at all?
Nah, don't believe in ghosts or gods or psychic powers or anything like that.
Not at all.
I mean, there's no evidence for them, and people have really tried.
Did you ever?
Yeah, when I was a kid.
Tell me about it.
So, I don't know how much I've ever told you, or how much Gregg has told you, but I didn't have the best childhood.
Yeah, I think I heard that. Why was it bad?
My dad didn't like me, and my mom didn't either. Like,
You don't have to talk about it if you don't want to. No, it's fine. My dad used to hit me a lot. My mom was probably worse. She, like, wouldn't feed me, which is why I really like cooking now. Angus. She'd, like, shove me into a pantry and slam the door really hard. All the stuff would fall off the shelves on top of me. Oh my god, Angus. I didn't know that at all. That's awful. She'd lock me in there for, like, a day at a time sometimes, or overnight, so I'd, like, try to develop psychic powers so I could, like, signal neighbors or unlatch the door. It didn't work, as you might guess. Did you ever tell anybody? I never did. I don't know why. After a while, I, like, started feeling guilty, too, for some reason. Like, this was something bad I was doing. Like, being abused? Angus, that's not your fault at all. You were a kid. Oh, don't worry. I know that now. Boy, do I ever. Question. Can I go kick all their asses? Like, I've got experience. I can F some shit up. Well, my mom is kind of old now. I still have to visit her sometimes. I have a brother. He's overseas in the army. And my dad left like 10 years ago, so who knows where he is or if he's even alive. If he is alive, I don't want to know about it. Angus, I just want to give you a hug forever. Well, I was luckier than a lot of kids. I'm just glad I didn't, like, yeah. Anyway, to your original question. Testing out my psychic abilities in the pantry made me really interested in both paranormal stuff and science. And I joined a skeptic society on the internet. That kind of ruined me on a lot of other supernatural bullshit. And it gave me something to solve. Something you could debunk or, you know, I don't know. Saved me a little bit, I guess. That's rough. Oh my god. This is so good. I guess when someone does all that stuff to you, like, make you do some bad things to yourself. But anyway, yeah. No ghosts or God. So, like, I feel like if I'd been through that, I'd be more likely to want to believe in God or something. Do you believe in anything at all? Well, so like the constellations. I don't believe there's a whale out there. But I believe that the stars exist and that people put the whale there. I don't know. We're good at drawing lines through space between the stars. Like, we're pattern finders. We'll find patterns. We, like, really put our heart and minds into it. And even if we don't mean to. So, I believe in a universe that doesn't care. And people who do. I don't know why that line hit me so hard. Oh my god. Oh my god. Okay. Yeah. Honestly, that's kind of the way I see a lot of it too. Because, I mean, I've mentioned before, I'm not religious. I grew up in a church. I actually still actively work in a church. I always felt really out of place with religion. And, you know, I took all these classes and I literally went to youth group every single week. I got an award for being the person at the end of one of the years when I was in, like, I don't know, fifth or sixth grade for, like, or not fifth or sixth, it would have been, like, it doesn't matter. Like, I was in middle school, and I, like, got an award for being the person, me and my sister both, for being the people who attended youth group the most. Especially being, growing up as a queer person, the church environment is really unwelcoming, and I think that turned me away from a lot of religion, and so many people use religion for hate. But at the same time, I don't hate religion, specifically Christianity. I can't really speak in terms of anything else. Everyone is absolutely able to have their own beliefs, and I never want to disrespect anyone's. But it's an interesting perspective working at a church, because I am in a Christian church every Sunday. Being somebody who does not believe in God, it's not that I actively think God doesn't exist. I just don't really care if God does or doesn't, because it doesn't really do anything for me. And so, but to be surrounded by people who do, and especially some of the, like, nice, caring people in the church, it makes me want. It's always such a bittersweet feeling, because it makes me be like, it's like, religion can be such a beautiful thing because it brings people together, and sometimes that can be really heartbreaking in a way, just to see these people who care so much and to want to be a part of that thing, because people do care. And I don't want to necessarily believe that all humans are inherently good, because I know that that's not I think for the most part I do. I try to believe that all humans are inherently good. I don't like to think that anybody was born to be evil. And so the concept of, like, people coming together in a way that religion often brings people together is something so beautiful, and I wish that there wasn't so much hatred around it. And anyways, really long tangent aside, that line hits really hard. pattern finders. I feel a lot of people don't think they found God, like God found them, when they were having bad times like you did. God never did. I was completely alone in the pantry. A few years later, Gregg did. God. Freaking Angus! Oh. So like, stars can stay up there and not give a shit about us. But this whale is pretty cool. You're an extremely good and smart person, Angus. I try. But I'm no more than anyone else. God. That was really good.
Yep.
Yep. I should come out here more often. Haha. Yeah. Don't look at him. Who? There's someone standing behind us. Oh my god! In the trees. Holy shit. Holy shit. What do they look like? Tall, wearing some kind of weird coat. Utility coat or something. Oh god. That's the ghost. I'm more worried about it being a living person, standing in the woods staring at us. God, oh god. Well, don't panic. Follow my lead. Hey there. Out for a hike. Nice night. He's not answering. That's a little hostile, right? It's definitely a little hostile. Hey! I know what you did. Mate, no. I saw you. Okay, well, we're gonna run now. We need to get the car. Sure, asthma. I got an inhaler. The good kind, too. No one in heaven or earth can stop me. Okay, let's go. Deep breaths. In. Out. Alright. Oh my god! You okay, big guy? Yeah, I'll be okay in a few minutes. I'm resilient. So that was it. That was the ghost. Okay. Or it was some weirdo who lives out there. They probably get lots of kids throwing parties back there. And the party we went to where you threw up. Ugh. That wasn't too far from there. What is nobody... What's wrong? Do you need me to pull over? Yeah, jeez. Let's get you home. No! I need to talk to everyone tonight. What? All of us. I need all of us. Thanks for, like, coming. Again, we live here.
Yeah, you're in my living room. I'll accept the thanks.
So, like, do you have any idea of what's going on? I have no idea. There's a ghost, and it's after me. I know you guys don't believe me.
It's not that I don't believe something's happening with you. I just don't know that it's a ghost. Yeah, dude, there are like 50 better explanations for all of this.
Like what?
You have like sudden stress migraines, and you saw something that freaked you out. It makes you stress out.
I get migraines.
And mate, you've gone through a lot of life changes recently, and I don't know, stress does weird things to people.
Okay, fine. Fine, whatever. Going up into the woods. I know this thing's up there. I know what I saw. If you don't believe me, that's fine. Go alone.
You're really gonna hike up past the basketball court? It's late, dude.
What do you all care? You don't believe me anyway. I'll go. Listen, I don't believe in ghosts, but I believe in you.
Aw, dude.
So let's go find your ghost.
I was fixing to say something like that, but you said it better.
You guys...
It's not even ghost hunting season.
Yeah, it's buck.
We're outlaws.
Thank you. Believing me.
Mostly I just don't want you wandering up around there alone. At night.
Close enough.
Alright. Let's hunt some ghost.
Thank you, guys.
Haven't been on a night hike in a long time. Gotta listen for owls.
Why?
No reason.
Alright. Out work in the morning. Let's go catch this ghost. Okay. No clues, but Angus saw him too. Okay. Angus is psychic, but his hat blocks it. Okay. Oh wow, we really are going. Look at us, our little squad. How have I never been back up here?
Ends his work. Nah, people are up here all the time. I came here when I was like 12.
What's up here?
It's all junk and trees and animals.
What is it, B?
Nothing.
Nothing?
I was praying.
Wow. Really?
Yeah, let's go.
Okay. I'm so tense right now. I can't jump. I don't like not being able to jump.
Wait. What? I think I heard an owl.
Oh, hun. Gregg got attacked by an owl, B.
What? When?
When we were breaking into the history place? I don't think they attack groups, but... if I get mauled to death, I warned you all. I'll punch away any owl that gets near you.
Aw, thanks, Cat. Big dangerous Gregg, scared of birds. Almost died from that owl!
That's so sweet. Okay. I'm so nervous, and I know I've been playing for a long time, but I don't care. Wow.
Gotta put all this stuff somewhere, I guess.
Do you remember this from when you were 12, Gregg?
Yeah, I was scared of it.
How'd they even get all this back up in here?
What's up?
Nothing. Just like, all this old stuff out here. It's here every night when you go to sleep.
So?
It's out here in the dark. So old. So old.
Dude, hey May!
I'm fine.
We should go back, this is stupid.
No, it's fine. Ghost hunt, woo, fun. Is this like the forest part from that one cutscene? It's red. I don't like it here. What the?
Huh? Oh my god.
Oh, no! At least awake already. Anyone got any juice? No, no, guys! Oh, hell. Guys, wait! If you knew this was gonna happen. You knew the moment you screwed this whole thing up. I didn't like you weren't on the other side of this before. It was a mistake! I owned up to it! Or this is you owning up to it. Aren't I allowed to make one mistake? One mistake? You lost a goddamn arm in front of the click-clack! Because you god knows what's gonna happen to this town. What was I supposed to do? It was your screw-up. Ugh, it's like stuck. It was like you couldn't have called any of us. I panicked, okay? I was embarrassed! Sure wish you called me, Lurf. Think any of us want to do this? Guys, we can figure something out. Nothing to figure out. But I got family. Lurv, don't insult us. You know you don't gotta worry about Genie and the girls. They'll be completely taken care of. They'll never want for nothing. He's not gonna budge that leg sticking straight out. Oh, hell. Stay, frick. Benny, you guys know me. All right, Dave, you hold him. I'm sorry, Lurv. You know we got no choice. And I'd appreciate it if you stopped laying a guilt trip on us. No! Hold him still. No! Ah! Still, this will go easier if... What? Alright, he's free. Lurf. What? Lurf. Hey, no one can hear this far out. You're just putting yourself to more anguish and... oh, hell, let's get this over with. You should just make this easy, Lurf. God, his bone's sticking out. The hell?
Shit.
May? My Borski? Run! What is happening? Oh! Oh my god, I'm supposed to be jumping! You took away my ability to jump! I didn't think I could jump! No, stop. Go away. Oh no, the end of everything, part four. Nice.
Yep.
Dude, you are way better at this than I am. I'm not this good at, like, anything.
I still play a lot. Got lots of old games at home. Collect them.
Huh, I never went over to your place. I don't take anyone there. Secret?
I live in a tree. I'd believe that.
Okay, well... Go... Huh? Guys! So, is she dead?
No idea. No response from her parents.
That's bad.
It's not great.
Jeez. Don't see the dude.
He was outside my building last night, late.
You call the cops?
Yeah, I called. They sent someone by. He was gone. So it's not illegal to stand in the street.
Getting dark earlier. I used to skate. I wasn't super good at it.
I could skate. I am a skater.
Great.
I do what I like.
Angus. Okay. Other way. Gotta save what I'm excited about.
I could use like 5 naps. 5 good naps and 1 nap bucket. Jump in.
Okay, so got brownies, sodas.
Hey, Captain.
Hey, Bug. You making like 3 dinners at once? Brownies are in the oven. Thinking about making the lasagna we got and forgot about.
We have lasagna?
Yeah, way back in the back.
I thought that was like the wall.
Nope.
Man, you should maybe go to sleep or something. You barely sat down in the past 24 hours.
Good dinner makes everyone feel better. Someone's gotta take care of you.
Dude, let me take care of you.
This stuff I'm doing, this helps me.
Okay, that's cool. We are gonna make it through this.
Love you.
Hey, just wanna say, it was cool of you to go to Possum Jump with May. I know the scout camp isn't, like, the most fun place from when you were a kid.
It's cool. Like, it was cathartic.
Nice.
I need you to defrost the lasagna. Or do I? Do you cook it frozen? I don't know. I want to keep playing.
Guys, this is a bad situation.
Yep.
Yes, sir. Wait, everybody shut up. What?
I heard it too.
Seriously, what?
There's someone standing outside the door.
What? Everyone be very quiet.
Crap. Guys, I'm gonna be really mean to you and to me. And I think we're gonna save there. Oh my god. Oh, I really don't want to keep going, but also I have no idea how long there is left. And I don't want to rush. Oh my god. Crusty sketches. Original concept sketches for the park investigation with Angus.
Oh my god, I don't know what's happening. Is there literally some, like, murder cult going around? Is May okay? Clearly something actually happened because everybody else is just back at the house. Back at Gregg and Angus's house. We told Germ.
Ugh. I'm really worried, but I've been playing for what? Between this one and the last one? Well over an hour now. So, I don't know. Let me know how long generally I've left, whether there's going to be... I think we're getting closer to ending, whether it's like one or two episodes or whatnot. So yeah, oh my god. I have so much, I'm so stressed. I got so much cute stuff this episode, but also so oh my god stuff. So yeah, I hope May is gonna be okay. I mean, I'm assuming she'll be okay. As playing as Gregg does not fill me with a lot of confidence. Everybody's really worried. Angus is really stressed. We just got the whole story. I hope her parents, Lori, whoever that guy was, whoever his family is, was he literally just getting like ripped apart? How did the person know May? I want to assume that like not the worst is happening, but the bone sticking out is bad. And the fact that they were like, you left an arm behind is pretty bad. Because we know that the person who the arm came from is apparently dead. So like, God. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. Please come talk to me about this game in the Discord. And without further ado, I'm gonna go. Thank you guys so much for watching. And I will see you all next time. Bye!